Welcome to this week's OK at Work with myself, Sarah Sawyer, my colleague, Russell Berger from the Offit, Kurman Labor and Employment Group. So this week we are talking about deductions from wages. So there are, you know, state laws and federal laws that both govern deductions from wages, and often in most circumstances, I'd say, just kind of broadly, you have to either have an employee's permission to deduct from their wages, or you have to be permitted by law to make a deduction. We see this a lot with, you know, the by law piece is often involves, you know, child support or different court orders involving wage deductions. But there are some tricky nuances to this, and what do employers need to keep in mind, Russell?
Yeah, well, you left off the most important one from the government's perspective, which is withholding for taxes. You don't need, the government will let you do that one too. But you know, what we see a lot of is employers who want to deduct something from an employee's pay because they didn't return equipment, they damaged equipment, they caused some kind of problem, or they just owe the employer money for any number of reasons. And that is really a state specific issue. So, you know, if you have employees spread out in multiple states, you really need to be conscious of what each state requires in this regard. You know, here in Maryland, where we are, the requirement is that you have written authorization. And if you get written authorization from an employee, then you're generally permitted to deduct from pay, provided, however, that the deductions from pay don't cause a reduction below the minimum wage as required by the state or the federal law. So that's really a starting point. So what we would generally advise clients is, you know, make sure first figure out what state law applies, and you may want to do it differently for different employers in different states, but make sure you have written authorization. If you're in a state like Maryland or any other state where it's permitted, make sure you have written authorization up front before you deduct from wages. And, you know, we would recommend that you have people sign forms, make it part of your credit card authorization process, make it part of your company equipment form, you know, create some process around this, so that, you know, you're getting these authorizations when, as an employer, you're taking the risk.
Yeah, and there are some exceptions to some of the general kind of rules around wage deductions. One of them, you mentioned the minimum wage issue, where you actually can, in some circumstances, take the employee's wages down below minimum wage in some states, in some circumstances. See, there's a lot of caveats here, but, you know, where you have advanced wages, or you have, you know, given a loan to an employee or things like that. Sometimes there's some exceptions to the rule there. Also, something that comes up often for my clients, not too often if they're doing their bookkeeping correctly, but overpayment of wages, accidentally paying an employee too much. So in those circumstances, then that falls outside of some of the typical rules on in most states and on the federal level, where you can actually go ahead and deduct more and you don't necessarily need the employee to sign off on it. As a best practice, though, often, you know, I'll counsel clients to try to work with the employee if they can, just to try to make sure that they are on the same page about getting the money back and what happened and things like that, just as a practical matter. But depending on your employees, sometimes that money might be gone. So, or it might not be as easy, or maybe the employee's not there anymore suddenly, or something happens. So there is some flexibility there. So some exceptions to the rule, but lots of nuance in this category for sure.
Yeah, and like the one fact pattern I think we see a lot of is the employee who doesn't return something at termination, or who owes money at termination for whatever reason, and the employer says, well, they need to return that $1,000 computer to me, but they haven't, so I'm just going to take $1,000 out of that final pay. And they don't have authorization, or they're in a state where it's not permitted. You know, if we take, let's use Maryland as an example, if you don't have authorization to do that, and you withhold that $1,000 from pay, you know, you may have evened things up from a practical standpoint, but you didn't pay $1,000 worth of wages that you were obligated to pay. It's not an exception to the wage law. As we've talked about before, the wage law entitles a plaintiff, an employee in Maryland, to sue for treble damages. So that $1,000 exposure is now a $3,000 exposure that you owe, plus the other side's attorney's fees, plus your own attorney's fees to deal with it. it doesn't make, I'm not saying it's the most practical or simple way of dealing with these challenges, but it's a way, it is the way, it's the law, and you've got to figure out ways to comply with it. So self-help contains a fair amount of risk for employers. So I think that's an important thing for employers to keep in mind.
Yeah, and to that point, I often see when I'm digging into employers' policies, if they're asking me questions around this, I see that they've made those types of deductions that you're describing pretty customarily, just without, you know, policies or deduction forms, and they often are just kind of doing it as a natural practice because it feels like something they should be able to do without realizing the risks involved. And you know, it can be remedied fairly simply in exactly what we were describing, putting a form together, you know, making sure you've got some policies up front and that understanding is there up front and that you do your homework to make sure. And a good, you know, based on what we see with wage and hour laws and the potential consequences there and how those things can balloon, I mean, I think just as a general piece of advice, we always just advise clients when anything touching wages, you know, you want to be cautious around because of that, just because it can turn into a much bigger problem than you were anticipating. And so, you don't want that to happen. So.
Right. Yeah. Plan ahead. Plan ahead before you take the risk.
Yeah. If it's wages, pause. At least just pause for a second. I think that's the key. So, well, thanks, Russell, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks, Sarah.